Hello guys, and welcome back to Call of Duty Fanatics YouTube channel. In today's video we are going to talk about a couple of interesting things that's surrounding Call of Duty Season 4. But before we start, I want to thank everybody on the significant increase in the channel views, which is the good news. The bad news is that despite having a couple of thousands of views on the channel in the last couple of days, the subscriber counts. So I would kindly ask you that you subscribe to our channel for great future content, and I promise you that you won't regret it, because that's one of the ways you will get the news from Call of Duty game in your news feeds as well, and notifications. And as I said, you won't regret it, because there's a ton of great content that we are preparing. Furthermore, one of the topics that I'm going to cover today is the teddy bears that are scattered all around the map. Now, probably most of you know that teddy bears are a big deal in a Call of Duty franchise ever since the first game, and they were there also connected to a bigger picture, Easter eggs, etc. Now, when we are talking about Verdansk teddy bears, there is, like, I'm not sure did anybody manage to count all of these teddy bears that are around, but ever since players and gamers were asking same question, why are those teddy bears present in the game, and are they actually leading us on some kind of a Easter egg, or it's just something else? Basically, what we managed to learn through the media in the last couple of days is basically the real truth why the teddy bears are here. While nobody haven't still excluded the possibility that we are going to get some kind of a Easter egg through the presence of teddy bears in the map, the true reason actually behind the teddy bears are in the game is because original gentleman who was the developer of the game, his daughter actually passed away. So it's a sad news, it's a sad reason why all of these teddy bears, and this is basically a tribute to his daughter. Of course, as I mentioned, in some previous Call of Duty games we had Easter eggs and we had mysteries connected to these teddy bears, but so far teddy bears that are in Verdansk are basically just a tribute to a girl, and actually to a daughter of the main developer of this game. Now, that's the most fresh story, correct me if I'm wrong, but anyways, I would really like to know, what do you think about this brand new, I would say, news? I won't say it's rumor, because it's coming from a pretty credible sources. Also, I want to warn you that there is a surge of YouTube videos currently explaining, and there are actually a couple of good videos that are actually showing how you can do a couple of Easter eggs, in the sense of solving an Easter egg with these teddy bears. Now, the videos look so authentic that even I got fooled when I was first time looking at the video. Now, basically the task is that you get your loadout, so pay it 10 grand, get your loadout, come here to this specific teddy bear that I'm showing, shoot him a couple of times, then you will hear like a wolf pack sound merging from, as the author of that video said, from the prison. And then when you go to prison, you need to find a teddy bear that's basically hidden in the locker, and then you have to shoot that teddy bear, and then magically bunker number 8 will open, which is the bunker that's right across the prison. Now, the video is pretty authentic, but it's fake. So you cannot, there is no Easter egg or any bunker openings with teddy bears. It's simply impossible. In order to open those bunkers with the great loot, you need to do, as we know, you need to find the red keycard. So beware of these videos, because I spent a couple of hours trying to do that, because in solo version of Battle Royale, it's almost, I would say, impossible to do it. I mean, it's not impossible, but it's very, very hard. So, but, you know, people are trying to get the attention, people are trying to get likes, get views. Oh, somebody is shooting at me. Get likes, get views, but they are not. They are making quite good fake videos that that some people are actually getting into those, and I admit I was one of people who got fooled by this. The next topic is that I want to cover is absence of plunder or blood money. For me in particular, this is a big loss, I would say, because we are already 3 or 4 days without plunder or blood money, which makes for me in particular this game kind of, I wouldn't say boring, but for many people this game is more than just going around and killing people. Big Call of Duty community and gamers that are treasure hunting, and that are constantly trying to solve the puzzles and mysteries. You also know that when you are playing Battle Royale, it's almost impossible to treasure hunt. So because of the smoke and everything in Plunder, you already had a little bit of space. There is less player than in Battle Royale, so you have in Plunder, you had roughly 100 players on the field, and then players are scattered in all corners of the map, and it's definitely easier, and then you don't have this pressure from smoke. So we could treasure hunt and explore the map in the plunder mode. Now, since plunder is turned off, it's very hard to make any significant progress in trying to explore and resolve the mystery of Bunker 10. Now, when I'm speaking about Bunker 10, actually, I will get back to Bunker 10, just I have to say that plunder is supposed to get back today. Why it hasn't come back today, that's a big question for Activision, and I hope that with tomorrow's update, because tomorrow update are bringing us new missions, new ghost intels, and I hope that with these new missions and new ghost intel, we will also get the plunder back, so we can again in peace start to explore the mystery for how to open new bunkers, which is Bunker 1, 3, and 10. And you already probably know, that's an old news, that Bunker 10 actually holds the biggest secret, the biggest mystery, which is the nuclear bomb or rocket, which is hidden under the monument of the on the south side of Verdansk city. Also, when we are speaking about Bunker 10, one thing that I managed to find out is that the mysteries for possibly solving the codes how to enter Bunker 10, 1 and 3 are also scattered all around the single the multiplayer maps, sorry. So basically there is a lot of clues and a lot of I would say Easter egg in a new trench map where you can basically enter the bunker, which is in the trench bunker, and of course there you find a lot of, again, very bizarre Easter egg. You find again a lot of teddy bears who are scattered around there in sitting in on one desk and making some kind of a plan. Now, if you go also for the hard hat map in multiplayer, now we can actually test this right now. I will show you. So we will go to multiplayer. Then we will go to the just a moment, we will go to the private match, of course, and we will take game setup map, we will use not hackneyard, hard hat, yeah. So bot setup, we don't have to have anything specific here, but if we start the match, you will see same as with the trench map, again, some numbers and some clues are appearing in this map, and when this loading screen is finished, I will exactly show you what kind of proofs and hints I found on this map. So we will just wait this to load. But basically, what am I talking about? It's the same numbers and same codes that we are seeing in bunker number 11, which was a big deal in the previous update. Okay, so let me just recall the memory where exactly I found it. Yeah.
Team deathmatch.
Okay.
We've got enemy inbound. Lock
it. So I'm here alone, so it's very easy to explore this. So for example, you see here 324517. So this is the same numbers that are appearing in bunker number 11. So, and there's another one, like when you crouch and when you go to the nuclear warheads, you will see this number 20. This could be 9 or 7, A14. So this previously wasn't here on this map, definitely. So wasn't here definitely, and all of a sudden these numbers are appearing everywhere in this map, and same here. So 324517. It's the same color and same paint that's written in the bunker 11. Again, 207 or 209 A14. There's also other like small letters. You see here M, then you see here what is this V, and then X, and then these arrows to look somewhere. Like I tried to explore this a little bit, but I couldn't find anything. But this is definitely a clue to something, probably the cipher codes that we are going to be able to use when those sheds around the Verdansk, new sheds around the Verdansk map, are probably open. So far, most of the people who are treasure hunting and exploring what's happening with bunker number 10 and how to open it are, by my opinion, a little bit going ahead of themselves, because like we have a couple of 5 or 6 or even 10 steps, but we don't have step 1. Like nobody have cracked the code how to enter bunker number 10, bunker number 1 and bunker number 3. The thing that bothers the community is that if you glitch inside those bunkers, you can like take the loot, take the weapons, take the money, everything is inside. Like, why the developers would just put loot boxes, crates and money inside if that's not meant to be entered? Like in previous occasions, the same thing happened with the bunker 11. Like people managed to glitch inside the bunker before they cracked the code with the phones, and people were regularly coming inside, taking the loot and everything, but nobody actually knew how to open that bunker. In that, until the community managed to crack the code with the Russian phones, with the Russian's numbers and Morse code as well. So I strongly believe that this bunker could be opened, and that community still don't know the code. However, as I said, players and treasure hunters are a couple of steps ahead, because they managed to get into those bunkers with drones glitching. So people were going in, like glitching and coming into the bunker regularly, normally, and exploring there, and they found actually these cipher codes, projects, etc., which basically led them to a one giant cipher code that needs to be solved, probably in order to launch the nuclear warhead, nuclear rocket. But anyways, it's very interesting. Now here, when I'm standing beside this box, this number is also appearing on a multiple places. It wasn't here before. It wasn't on the Verdansk map as well before, but it's now appearing on multiple boxes in a multiplayer and on a Verdansk map, which is also very strange. Could be a clue to something, but as I said, community haven't solved this mystery, and Like, we know everything. We know what's going to happen. We know that there will be a cipher code. We know absolutely everything. But unfortunately, we don't know the very first step, and that's how to open the bunker 1, 3, and 10. But anyways, as I said, community is making a certain progress, and I hope that in the next couple of days, when plunder or blood money is coming back, that we will be able finally to get the numbers and to get the code and to crack the code how to enter the bunker, bunker 10. Anyways, guys, that would be it for today. That's the material that I wanted to cover with you. Again, thank you for your attention, and thank you for your kind support in the last couple of days. And if you like this video, please hit that like button along with the subscribe button as well. And as I said on the beginning of this video, you won't regret it, because you will get all the latest news and all the latest videos in your inbox. So I'll catch you guys next time, and stay good. Bye bye.